In this lesson, we'll finish the sample project model. We'll construct the central stairwell using Hotlinked models to speed up working with repetitive elements. We'll create stairs, elevators, and partition walls, and get to know the parametric library parts of ArchiCAD. All measurements are in millimeters unless otherwise stated. Let's open the Office Building 2 PLN plan file from the ArchiCAD Training Series 4, Demo Files, Startup Files folder. You may also continue the project that you completed in Lesson 1. The stairwell is a repetitive part in the building. We will create some of its parts in the main file, and then we will continue developing it in a separate Hotlinked module file. Hotlinked modules allow you to store typical or repetitive parts of your building in an external file and reuse them by hotlinking them in as many copies as needed into the current project or another ArchiCAD file. The main advantage of this solution is that whenever the content of the Hotlink module is changed, all the placed instances in your projects will be automatically updated. First, let's create the outlines for the central part of the building, between the two towers. Activate Story 1 from the project map of the Navigator, because we'll start drawing the walls on the first story. Activate the Wall tool in the Toolbox and open its Settings dialog. Display the Geometry and Positioning page. Set the height of the default wall to link to the second story. Make sure that the composite structure is selected. Select the 250 block insulated aluminum sheet composite structure. Select Core Inside reference line. Make sure that the structural bearing layer is selected. Display the model page of the settings dialog and override the surface materials to Paint 1. Click OK to close the settings dialog. Select the single geometry method in the info box. Start drawing the wall segment from the right to the left on the E axis, starting from E8 to E5 as shown on the screen. Make sure that the reference line of the new wall connects the reference lines of the vertical walls. Zoom in if necessary. Keep the Shift key pressed so that the horizontal angle is fixed, and move the cursor to the left side of the right tower. Now let's select the wall. Activate the Edit, Move, Mirror a Copy command from the menu. You may also activate the same command from the context menu. Click on the horizontal grid line below the wall. As you move the cursor, a ghost display of the mirrored elements appears. Click again on the same grid line to complete the mirror axis. The new instance of the wall is placed. Now we're going to create some internal concrete walls. Open the Wall Settings dialog and display the Geometry and Positioning page. Enter -200 for wall top offset. Select Basic Structure. Set the building material to reinforced concrete, structural. Enter 200 mm for wall thickness. And finally, set the reference line to outside face. Click OK to close the dialog. Draw the wall from the column's corner in the axis C6 to the column's corner in the axis E6, as presented on the screen. In a similar fashion, place a horizontal wall between axes D6 and D7. Draw a horizontal wall segment to connect the vertical walls. Please note how the columns are automatically intersected with the walls at the grid intersection points of D6 and D7. Select all the newly created 5 walls. Choose File, External Content, Save Selection as Module from the menu. Locate the Demo Files folder on your computer and create a new folder here called Exercise. Enter Staircase for module name and click Save to proceed. With this click, you've saved the selected elements into an external module file and at the same time placed one instance of this hotlinked module in the host file. Now, if you select any of the previously created walls, their element information pop-up tag states that they're part of a hotlinked module. In many respects, a hotlinked module is very similar to external reference files, or XREFs. It resides outside the project file, but is linked to the central host file. If changes occur in the module file, the host file is updated to show these changes. However, unlike a reference file, the elements of the hotlinked modules are actually placed as elements into the host file, so if the external data is not available or if the file is missing, the information is still not lost and remains available within the project file.